let me tell you what I'd wish I'd known. When I was young and dreamed of turtles. You have no control what they do with their decorations, how they eat, how nice they are, what size they grow, how long they live, or how much they poop in the tank. Yeah. Okay, that's what we're talking about today. What is up, guys? It is the Turtle Girl. Welcome to the channel, or welcome back to the channel. Today we are talking about things I wish I knew before I got a turtle, because now I've owned turtles for, I think, over 3 years now. Maybe it's 4 years. How long ago was 2016? So today we're talking about things I wish I knew before I got a turtle, because there were some things that I was expecting and some things I weren't, and I want to help you all out who haven't gotten turtles yet, or maybe you already have and maybe you already learned this stuff the hard way, but hopefully this benefits some of you who have not gotten a turtle yet and are doing some research and thinking about it, so this should be fun. Now, of course, there are some obvious things that you should know before you get a turtle and things that you should expect. One of them being its lifespan. I mean, it is a turtle. It can live upwards of 20 years. Some make it to 30, 40, even 50. So you have to know that they'll live a long time. Also, if you're gonna go for something like a slider or a cooter or even a map turtle, they can grow pretty large, so know of your space commitment, but we'll get into some of that later. So now let me talk about some stuff that I personally wish I knew before I got a turtle. The first thing was a really big thing for me, and that is, turtles are definitely more look, don't touch animals. What I mean by that is I like to describe them as underwater puppy dogs. They might swim up to the glass to greet you. I mean, they probably will, and they'll probably start begging too. But really, they're not the type of pet that you'll take out of the tank and let them chill on the floor or sit still with you on the couch and watch Netflix or binge watch The Mandalorian on Disney Plus. They're not gonna do that with you. They like to move around, and usually if they're out and about in the house and there's really no purpose to it, that honestly can just stress them out. So if you're the type of person who wants a pet that you can like handle and hang out with, then turtles probably aren't for you, because they're just really not handling pets. They're super fun to watch. A lot of turtles are very, very active, but you have to have that mindset of them being like glorified fish in a sense. I mean, I hate to say it like that, but it's kind of like what they are. You basically just leave them in the tank and only take them out when you have to either feed them in a separate container or when you want to take them outside into the sunlight to bask. And honestly, this was slightly disappointing for me, because I've always liked pets that I can get more hands-on with. But I definitely do appreciate fish and those types of pets. I just didn't expect that from a turtle. So now you know, turtles are not really the most handleable type of pets. Next thing I wish I knew was that aquariums can be very high maintenance. Now, especially if you're not coming from a background of keeping fish, owning a box full of water can be time consuming, and there's a big learning curve when it comes to like the nitrogen cycle and water changes and filtration and all this crazy stuff that comes along with owning an aquarium. Now, if you've kept fish before, turtles should be easy peasy, you're used to all of this, but if you're coming from the reptile side or from a side that hasn't ever kept any kind of aquarium before, it can be difficult, and so you definitely need to be learning about things like the nitrogen cycle and how filtration works and the fact that you will need to do water changes possibly on a weekly or bi-weekly basis in order to keep the tank clean. And because of that, turtles are not necessarily the easiest pets to keep because of the maintenance that goes into their aquarium. Think about it this way. Turtles poop in their aquarium. Maybe they even eat in their aquarium. And all of that waste stays in the water that's in that little glass box. And even if you have a filter that's processing the water, that's still the same water in the aquarium. So it's necessary to do water changes to take out some of that waste and put in fresh water. So aquariums can be difficult for some people, and that's something you need to consider if you want to get a turtle. Another thing about turtles is that they can be very destructive when it comes to the like decorations and things you put inside their tank. And so if your goal is to have a tank that has like live plants and is super nicely decorated and looks beautiful and is aesthetically pleasing, a turtle may not be the right pet for you. Most, if not all, turtle species tend to be very curious and will nose around their environment and push rocks around and push wood around and dig up plants and eat plants. So that's something you have to be prepared for if you would like a turtle. I didn't really know this. I kind of read about it, but I didn't expect that they would totally, you know, destroy any plants I put in there. So like, when I first got Nemo, I put a bunch of Anubias in there, which is a type of aquarium plant. And It took like maybe 3 days and he chewed off a bunch of the leaves. So that was that. There were not going to be any kind of plants in that tank. So that's why now all my turtles basically have what's called hardscape, which is basically just rocks and wood, because they can't move those around as easy. And even if they do, it's not going to do anything to them. It just, you know, affects how it looks. In fact, if you look at this tank behind me, when I first set it up, all the branches were like positioned. So they're coming up out of the water and there's like a good composition. But Hoku knocked them all over. So you have to know that if you're gonna have a turtle, they're gonna do their own thing when it comes to redecorating, and that's just a fact that you have to accept when you own a turtle. Next thing I wish I knew about turtles is that they don't necessarily want tank mates, and fish tank mates can potentially end up as food. So if you want to have fish with a turtle, or you're thinking, I already have a fish tank, let's add a turtle in there and see what happens, could very well end up that does not work out, because turtles are just naturally opportunistic feeders. So if they think they can eat a fish, they will. And some turtles are more carnivorous than others, so they'll actually like actively predate on the fish. So if you're thinking that you'd really like to have a fish and a turtle tank, you really need to carefully think about what kind of turtle you want, because some turtles tend to do better with fish than others. And so basically my point is just know that the turtle can and will eat fish if given the chance. Another thing is that turtles are not always like nice or friendly. Now I know I talked about how you can't really handle turtles, but you know, you still can interact with them. You can still teach them to, like, you know, eat food out of your fingers, but some turtles will try to bite you. So this should not come as a surprise, and this should be something that you should know about when you get a turtle. Now obviously there are like general care things, like give it a big enough tank, and you need to provide good filtration, and have a nice basking area with heat and UVB bulbs, but that's kind of general care stuff you can find out through research. The stuff I mentioned today was just things that I myself wish I had known before getting a turtle, and also some things like I didn't really expect. If you own a turtle and have other things that I did not mention in this video that you wish you'd known, definitely drop those in the comment section down below. I'm sure many people would be interested in hearing your thoughts and experiences. And I hope this video was helpful to you guys. If you did enjoy it, feel free to drop a thumbs up down below. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you all next Friday. Have a turtly awesome day. Bye-bye.